What's good? It's AP. One in a billion, and then I'm back. Listen, I'm back, part two of talking about my beautiful black women. Alright? And I gotta take the hat off for this. Yeah, I had to represent NY, Brooklyn, but I'm gonna take the hat off for this, alright? This is all I got to say. Black women are so beautiful. They're some of the most beautiful creatures on this planet. They're so talented. They go through so much. You know what I mean? A lot of them, they have to go through so much more than other races of women do. You know what I mean? Some races of women, that they can just be behind the closet and nobody really noticed them. But people always notice a black woman. And the black woman is so ridiculed, especially in these times. And this time, this day and age, it saddens me when I see and when I hear young black men making statements like, oh, yo, black women is too loud. Yo, they ugly. Their hair is not come on. Are you serious, man? If you can say out your mouth that a black woman is not beautiful and that you don't want to be with a black woman, you're lying to yourself and to everybody. Listen, this is what it is. A lot of dudes are intimidated. They're scared by black women. They don't know how to approach a black woman. Like, a lot of dudes are afraid of rejection. They scared to be rejected. And, you know, not to say nothing, but just in my experience, all the races, white women, they're easier. They just have a more laid back approach. You know what I mean? Like, it might be like a fist bumping, like up and up approach, but I mean laid back, where like it's easier to talk to them than it might be a black woman for some. So it seems like as a result of that, a lot of guys have been starting to talk to white women. I have no problem with that. You can talk to whoever you want to talk to. I done been with white women, I done been with black women, I done been with Asian women, I done been with Lebanese women, I done been with you name it, man. Spanish women, it doesn't matter. You know what I mean? So, but at the end of the day, I still respect all of those races. I respect all different races of people, and I respect people's ethnic background. You know what I mean? I respect ethnic makeup. Matter of fact, it intrigues me to find out about people's background and where they came from, you know what I mean? And to learn their languages and all that. So shout outs to all my peoples. You know what I mean? Y'all know who y'all are. But anyway, all I'm just saying is, young dudes out there, especially the black dudes, your moms is black, man. Your moms is an American African, or she might be a Caribbean American. She might be whatever, you know what I mean? If your mom's is that and your sister is that, don't let no rap song, don't let no rappers, no country rappers that ain't been taught better, that are a product of white supremacy, influence you that your black women, your own mother, your sister is not beautiful, because they are beautiful. They are beautiful beyond beauty, you know what I mean? And they deserve to be lifted up. They deserve to be praised for being who they are, for doing so much, because they go through so much. Even these little dolls that's out there don't really want to depict them in a beautiful light, yet they still overcome, you know what I mean? In the job field, they get treated bad in the job field. It's hard for them to move up in positions, you know what I mean? That's why you only hear about a few successful stories of, you understand what I'm saying. So pretty much, all I'm saying is this. Don't get the game twisted. Black women are beautiful and desired by all. They're desired by the white man, they're desired by the Asian man, they're desired by the white woman. the white woman, and all other women, a lot of women, they try to emulate their bodies and bite it, get Botox, you know, Angelina Jolie and all these girls get their lips all perked up and then they get celebrated. Whose lips are always perked up? A black woman. You know what I mean? I see all these pictures on Instagram and all these sites, new girls, new poses to put their lips out. Black girls, some of them copy of it. Some black girls copy of it. Y'all lips is already big. Y'all don't even gotta copy that. They trying to make their lips look bigger. You don't gotta do nothing. You know what I mean? Just be you and people will love you. But this is one thing I will say. Now, the black woman, yeah, a lot of men have said that black women are loud or that they're hard to talk to or this and that. Now, as a black woman, I know you guys are so prideful. I know that you always used to fighting. Maybe you shouldn't fight. Maybe you should improve yourself. Maybe you should try to be sweeter. Maybe you should take some qualities that some women have in other races. As opposed to just taking their hair. As opposed to taking their hair, because I really don't care about the hair stuff. You know what I mean? I mean, how would you feel if you saw me wearing, if I bought some dude's hair, you know what I'm saying? I bought somebody straight hair and put it on my head. Y'all would look at me like I'm a fool. Y'all would think, yo, this dude got no confidence in himself at all. So, you know what I mean? I'm just gonna leave it at that. So, but what I will say, like I said, take some of the good qualities from other people. All of these different people, we're all on this earth for a reason. We're all here together. And, you know what I mean? We need to learn from each other. So there are good qualities to learn. Like, everybody want to diss Miley Cyrus and all that. And I be getting on her too, but guess what? She obviously wants some of the qualities that black women have. Because she out there trying to twerk. She out there trying to do what we do. You know what I'm saying? So, learn some qualities, pick up some stuff from other ethnic groups and people as well, and help and allow those qualities to help you improve on who you are so you can be better for you and be better for your future spouse. So, all of you that leave all of these comments, I get all these emails and all the time they're like, oh, the black man is doing this to me and oh, I don't know if I can find the right man. Listen, you can find the right man, but you gotta make a change within your own self and definitely love yourself more than anything and have that relationship. If you don't have the relationship with your physical father, make sure you have that relationship with Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, your spiritual father. You know what I mean? So that's all I wanna say. I just love uplifting my people. I don't care if it get one view. I don't care if it gets a million views. I don't care if y'all get mad. Like I know whenever I get on this tip, they get mad. They get mad. They don't want to promote me no more. But I gotta do this because it's in me to uplift my people. So here I am.